I'm not worried.
Glory, hallelujah, amen. Praise the Lord.
You're now watching.
Greetings. I'm allnetzten Orts in Anger. I once starred in a film where the end of the world was imminent. It was very scary.
And I'm Linda Hammett-Up. I starred in that same movie. That scenario was nothing compared to what will really happen in the future.
On God's judgment day.
It all began in the Garden of Eden, when Adam disobeyed God, giving power on earth to Satan, and bringing sin and death to the human race. But God promised a Redeemer would one day be born, who would destroy the work of the devil.
Satan tried to corrupt the world and destroy God's plan. But God always had people who were willing to believe his promise.
Daniel, a prophet of God, revealed how kingdoms of the world would rise and fall throughout history. But in the end, God would destroy all man's kingdoms and set up his own eternal kingdom.
The time finally came when the Savior was to be born. All heaven rejoiced. But the evil one wanted to destroy him.
He lived a perfect life. He went about doing only good. But eventually, his enemies were successful in seeing him crucified.
What seemed like defeat was actually a victory. Christ arose from the grave. The first Adam bucked and stepped to all mankind. But the second Adam, Christ, conquered and stepped, making it possible for all men to have eternal life.
However, even though all men can be saved, not all are willing to receive the gift of life paid for at the cross. Satan has deceived most of the world into believing there are other means of salvation.
The day is fast approaching when God will set up his kingdom on earth. But first, he must put an end to the present world system. The devil will not give up his power easily. Many calamities must first come upon the inhabitants of the world.
Those who have accepted Christ will escape the wrath of God on the earth. Just before the tribulation begins, they will be called up to heaven. The world will be in chaos following this event. A leader will arise who will temporarily bring peace.
The nation of Israel will hail this leader as their Messiah, having refused Jesus Christ. But he is really the great Antichrist. After 3.5 years of lies, he will turn on them.
Just as God protected the Christ child from King Herod, he will spare Israel from the Antichrist. Millions of people turn to God during the 7 years of devastation and plagues. But the heart of the Antichrist only becomes harder. He persecutes and kills those who do not follow him.
The plagues become more and more severe. But the Antichrist and his followers refuse to give glory to God. The Antichrist assembles an enormous army and attacks Israel. She seems to be hopelessly surrounded.
Then Jesus Christ suddenly appears in the eastern sky with armies of his saints and angels. The nation of Israel will then recognize him as their Messiah and be saved.
The Antichrist and his false prophet are captured and thrown alive into the lake of fire. Then Christ slays the rest of the army with the sword of his mouth.
Blood from the Antichrist's army rises to the horse's bridles. Vultures feed on the dead for 7 months.
Satan is bound in chains by a mighty angel and sealed in a bottomless pit for 1,000 years. Then Jesus Christ reigns during the millennium. It is a time of peace and prosperity the world has never known before.
The devil is released from the bottomless pit after the 1,000 years are up.
He deceives millions into rebelling against the reign of Christ. His massive army attacks Jerusalem. Fire comes down from heaven and kills the entire army.
Satan is cast into the lake of fire, where the Antichrist and false prophet are.
All who died without accepting Christ will then be resurrected. They must stand before God at the great white throne of judgment, because their names will not appear in the book of life. They will be cast into the lake of fire. There they will suffer great torment forever.
The earth will then be wondrously transformed. The city of New Jerusalem will come down from heaven for God's people to dwell in.
It will be a marvelous place, with gates made of pearl and streets made of gold. No one may enter but those who have been redeemed by Christ.
Best of all, God himself and his Son will dwell in the midst of the city. And it will stand for all eternity.
Honored, what do you think? Can any of this be true?
Let me put it this way, Linda. I am an actor. I don't have to believe what I am saying. I just read my lines.
Oh no. It's happening.
What's going on? What's happening?
It's the rapture.
Now I'm worried.